How you doing? Nice shirt.
Not too bad. Yourself? Nice hat.
Thanks.
I'm digging it. What's up?
See the Master Sword in the bottom there?
No, I had not seen the Master Sword in the bottom here. There you go. Very nice. That is, yeah, that is printed, huh?
Hell yeah. It's printed with our materials.
Right here.
Old version of our materials, actually.
So what do you got going here?
90% metal with a 10% PLA infill. You can actually be fired in a kiln to remove the PLA and then you have a pure metal object, or you can just polish it with the PLA still in it.
Is pretty nifty.
These were all printed on this printer. This has been fired in a kiln, so now it's just pure metal object.
That is nifty.
A regular desktop printer. As you can see, it's pretty flexible.
No way.
That is pretty cool.
It's really fun to work with, man.
I bet.
We have bronze, copper, and we have stainless steel. He's got my Colossus stainless steel. Thanks, man. That's our stainless steel. That's our newest. 316L.
That is nifty.
I had to print stainless steel. I had to print Colossus first.
Absolutely. I mean, who else would you print?
Right? So, that's only a 40% infill. This is 100% infill. That's copper. That's what it looks like when it comes off the printer bed.
Okay. So how much post-process work does it take to get the final finish like this?
I mean, that's kind of up to you. It doesn't take too much work. It depends on the level of shine you want. This is just needle files, some sound buff, some ZAM in a couple hours. This was 20 grades of sandpaper and nothing else. Just to prove bright I could get it shine with
that. Have you tried, like, sandblasting or anything? Like some pecan shell stuff?
I sandblast the stuff that I fire. You know, because it has a layer of carbon on the outside after you fire it. So the easiest time-saving thing you can do is sandblast it before you polish it up. So I do that with the stuff I fire. Not so
I was
much,
curious if you had tried that or not.
I haven't really tried it with unfired stuff too much, though.
Right.
I like to get in there with my hands and not with the elbow work. But, you know, I imagine you can get some results with sandblast or trying some different materials. I just haven't played too much with it yet.
I got you. Yeah, I've put my fair share of elbow grease into a whole lot of post processes like that. So the best process you can get to cut as many corners off of that before you have to do hand finish work.
Right,
is always a bonus to me. You know what I mean? So now, what is that?
This is right, Dr. There. Strange's eye of Agamotto.
Okay, so, yeah. Very nice, very nice.
It's really fun stuff to work with.
That is pretty nifty. How much does the filament like that run? These are what, sample packs?
These are the 100 gram samples. Copper's 10, bronze is 20, and stainless is 30. So, well, we've got everything up to a kilo.
Okay. Is this y'all's card right here?
Yes, it is.
I'm going to steal one of those.
Cool.
And I will probably be back over here to harass you again in a little while.
I highly recommend it, man. And another cool thing you can do with this stuff that I enjoy is you can do multi-part prints. And because of just the nature of how it works, when it's warm, it's like clay. So you can actually take a soldering iron and multi-part print, and you can make the seam disappear and join them together. And then if you're so inclined, you can also fire them. It will be one solid piece of metal when it was done firing.
Okay, what are you firing in them? Like kiln?
Kiln, I mean, well, the copper and the bronze, we just use like a little pottery kiln that we got off Craigslist for like $300. So not a big investment.
I haven't picked one of those.
Stainless, you got to be a little more, get a little more serious because it, you know, centers at 2200. So with the way kilns work, once you get over 2000 degrees, the price starts jumping up.
Oh, I know.
Big increment.
I know.
So.
One of these days. Okay, I mean, right. I've got a propane forge.
Okay.
And my partner's picked up an anvil and a couple other things. So
sure.
One day soon, I'm probably going to get around to building myself a propane foundry.
Nice.
I'll start doing some casting.
We just picked up a nice high-end dental kiln so we can start sintering our stainless. It's pretty sweet. Vacuum kiln also has, you can do the gas with it. We only had it for like a week, so I mean, I barely got to play with that. When you're firing it, you gotta put it in an investment we make. because oxygen is the enemy of metal when it gets hot. But if you have a vacuum kiln, then you can just use sand as your support while you're firing.
It'll probably be a while before I get around to a kiln, because our electronics guy has one, so I just got to drive, 40 minutes, and I can go heat treat or whatever I need.
Right, right.
So I haven't got one of my own. But it might be a little while.
You can do pretty stuff, just polish it,
Yeah.
It just depends on what you're looking to do. Whether it be just, making cool nerd stuff, or whether we've got companies that are manufacturing with our product, or, people like to do prototyping.
We do a lot of prototyping.
It's great for prototyping. I mean, you're talking about, printing in metal, for us, you had to have like a $50,000 printer, But we've printed on a printer box simple with our stuff, so.
Are you looking to expand the varieties of metal that you've got so far?
We've always got stuff down the pipeline. Like, this won't be available for a little while yet, but this is tungsten. It has the same density as lead with the plastic in it.
That is pretty interesting.
Yep.
I don't know.
Yeah, I've using that to store radioactive medicines in.
Radioactive medicines.
Yep.
That's reassuring.
This one particularly hasn't had them in it, but yeah.
That's fun. That's pretty awesome. Well, thank you, sir. I appreciate it.
All right, man.
Thank you very much. Nice to meet y'all, too. I'll swing back in a little bit.
Sounds good.
You go, trophy under here. This trophy right here.
Right here.
MVP award for Kent State. It's the first 3D printed trophy ever.
Nice.
For a big, like, for a major thing, like.
Right, right. MVP, I got you.
Just for Kent State, so.
That's pretty cool. That is pretty cool.
Yeah, we're pretty happy with what we do.
So am I.
Excellent.
I'll be back by in a little while. It was right, nice to meet you, sir. I'm Santi.
My name's Bruce.
Bruce? Nice to meet you, Bruce. Don't have too much fun.
I'll try not to.